In the previous class, we were discussing about the three-phase unbalanced system, and based on that, we have defined the power factors. So this is just the recap from the previous class, where we have studied three-phase unbalanced system and defined the three types of apparent powers. The first one was about the vector apparent power, the second one arithmetic apparent power, and third one was effective apparent power. The vector apparent power is the mod of the phasor sum of SA, SB, and SC. And SA is the mod of sum of the individual mod of each phase apparent power. While as the effective apparent power was 3 into BE into IE, where BE and IE are defined on the basis of constant losses and the constant power output. So this was the IE term and this was the BE term. We also have found the power factors corresponding to these apparent powers. Since P is same for all three cases, there is no ambiguity about P. So P remains constant. The only term which varies is S, or apparent power. So in case of the vector, it is SB. In case of the arithmetic, it is SA. And in case of the effective, it is SE. Accordingly, we define the term PFB, PFA, and PFE. Power factor was found for each case, and we could establish the identity between these apparent powers. Holds this relationship that SE is greater than SA is greater than SB, and therefore the effective power factor is less than the arithmetic power factor, which is less than the vector power factor. Okay, so as we have seen from the study, that PFE is the least one for a given unbalance, and hence we prefer the value of PFE to design the distribution transmission network so that we can take care of the higher value of currents, because when we take the low power factor, we design for the high value of current. That is the basic idea. In the previous example also, we have found the exact value of these power factors, that is the power factor based on the vector apparent power was 1.0, and based on the arithmetic it is 0.866, and based on the effective apparent power it is 0.707. So you can see that the power factor based on the effective apparent power is less than this, and this is less than this. So we will prefer this power factor to design the distribution network or power system network. Also, we have defined one more term, that is called unbalanced power, which is defined as SE square minus S plus square, where S plus is P plus square plus Q plus square square. This is the positive sequence apparent power. This is also equal to 3 mod of BA plus IA plus. And the expression for SE is 3 into BE into IE, where BE and IE have been defined earlier. So this was this simple case of three-phase system, where the three-phase voltages and currents are unbalanced, but there nature is sinusoidal, there are no harmonics present in the voltage and current. Now, we will take the next case where we have three-phase system, balanced system, but it is non-sinusoidal. So basically it means it has harmonics at different frequencies, let us say 2 omega, 3 omega, 4 omega, and so on. But these harmonics are balanced. There are two possibilities. Harmonics could be balanced and harmonic could be unbalanced. It is the same thing as fundamental balance, fundamental unbalance. Similarly, with respect to other frequencies, there could be balance and there could be unbalance. Alright, so we will first consider the case of three-phase non-sinusoidal balance system. How do we represent this system? Let us first talk about the voltage. So for three-phase balance system with harmonics, we express the voltages as given in these equations, VA and VB and VC. A phase, B phase, C phase. So A phase is expressed as root 2 Vn, RMS value is Vn for nth harmonic, sine n omega t minus alpha n, where n varies from 1 to infinity. Or you can write in terms of the fundamental and other harmonics. The fundamental is root 2 V1 sine omega t minus alpha 1 plus n from 2 to infinity root 2 Vn sine n omega t minus alpha n. So here we have split it in the form of the fundamental and the other remaining harmonics. For phase B, we can express B phase voltage. First, this remains same because it is a balanced system. So magnitude of the corresponding harmonic or fundamental is balanced. Therefore, the value of that voltage is same. So Bn will not change. Then sine n omega t minus 120 degree. See how we express. We simply replaced the omega t term by omega t minus 120 degree. Then it becomes phase V. That's only difference. For phase V, omega t will be replaced by omega t minus 120 degree. Less things are same, phase angles are same because they are balanced harmonics or balanced fundamental. Again, we can express this in form of the fundamental and bezels. Again, we can express in form of the fundamental of this voltage and the harmonic components. And similarly, we express VC, where omega t becomes omega t plus 120 degree because C phase leads A phase by 120 degree. The rest things are same. So this is the fundamental of C phase voltage here, and this is the fundamental, and these are the harmonics for the C phase voltage. Once we know how to represent three phase balance system with harmonics, then we express the current in a similar fashion. So you can see here the currents are expressed in terms of their RMS values of the fundamental and harmonics. This is the A phase, this is the B phase, and this is the C phase. Now here this is IN corrected. So root 2 IN sine n omega t minus beta n. This phase angle is beta n. Earlier it was alpha n. The angle of current is beta n. The angle is different. It may be lag or lead depending upon the load. Then we split into the fundamental and its harmonic components. Similarly, we write for phase B current, that is IVT equals root 2 IN sine n omega t minus 120 degree. So again omega t has to be replaced by omega t minus 120 degree. The rest part is same. So this is root 2 IN sine n omega t minus 120 minus beta n. This can be again split it into the fundamental and the harmonic components of B phase current. Likewise, we can find out the phase C, where we express the current as root 2 I n sin n omega t plus 120 degree. So now omega t is omega t plus 120 degree. And we can expand in form of the fundamental and the harmonics. So this is root 2 I n sin omega t plus 120 minus beta 1 plus n equals 2 to infinity root 2 I n sin n omega t plus 120 minus beta n. N is outside the omega t plus 120 degree or omega t minus 120 degree. Remember it. N is not like this. Rather, n is like this. N is not correct. Omega t plus minus 120 degree depending upon the phase. So n is outside omega t. It's a omega t replacement, not an omega t replacement. Okay. Therefore, n is outside the bracket. So I hope you have learned how to express the voltage and current for three-phase unbalanced system with harmonics. But now we will study what is the effect of these harmonics on two important parameters. Number one, the neutral current, and number two is the line-to-line voltage. And then we will study the various power components such as reactive power, the apparent power, and the power factors. So let us first take the neutral current and try to understand that what will be the neutral current for this system in a three-phase power network. So neutral current, we can find out by phasor sum of the each frequency component of the currents. But since here there are different frequencies, so we cannot really sum these phasors together. We can sum the phasors of same frequency, but you cannot sum the phasors of different frequencies. So we have to go to the time domain where we can sum the currents which are varying with time. For example, in this diagram, if you see, this current is IA, this is IB, okay, you can write IB here, this is IA, and this is IC. Using the Kirchhoff current law, this current is IN. So obviously, IN must be equal to IA plus IB plus IC. The incoming currents are equal to the outgoing current. Basically, it is a law of energy conservation. If you study Kirchhoff's voltage law and current law, they are nothing but the laws of energy conservation. IA, IB, IC have fundamental and harmonic components. So let us say fundamental is expressed by IA1. Second harmonic is IA2, then IA3, then IA4, IA5, and so on. Is that fine? And similarly for phase B, we have IB1 plus IB2 plus IB3 plus IB4 and so on. For C phase, we have IC1 plus IC2 plus IC3 plus IC4 and so on. We have written in this kind of arrangement to understand that how the different frequency components of the current or voltage contribute to neutral current. So these form actually the set of the fundamental. This is second harmonic. Okay, then you have a third harmonic of each phase component, and then finally you have fourth harmonic, and so on. This will carry on. Fifth, seventh, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, and so on. Now, to understand their nature, we can express these components in form of the time domain expressions. This is I1, I2 and I3. Then I4, I5, I6 and so on. So you can see here, the first one is root 2 is common to all, so that we have taken outside. Inside there is I1 sin omega t minus beta 1. This is IA1. This is IA1. This is IV1. Omega t is replaced by omega t minus 120 degree. And this is IC1. Omega t is replaced by omega t plus 120 degree. Similarly, for second harmonic, the frequency is 2 omega. So now you have a 2 omega here. So 2 omega t minus beta 2. IV2 will be 2 omega t minus 120 degree minus beta 2. So IC2 will be 2 omega t plus 120 degree minus beta 2. Now here some simplification is there. This 2 omega t minus 120 actually becomes 2 omega t minus 240 degree minus beta 2. Minus 240 is same as plus 120 degree. So we can also write it 2 omega t plus 120 degree minus beta 2. Alright, so we can also express this as 2 omega t plus 120 degree minus beta 2. Or you can also write 2 omega t minus beta 2 plus 120 degree. Similarly, you can write this one 2 omega t minus beta 2 minus 120 degree, because this is 2 omega t plus 240 degree. Okay, if you look this expression, this is 2 omega t plus 240, which means minus beta 2, and that becomes 2 omega t minus beta 2 minus 120 degree. So we can write this expression as 2 omega t minus beta 2 minus 120 degree. Similarly, for third harmonic, is quite simplified, because this is I3, and this is 3 omega t minus beta 3. This is 3 omega t minus 120, 3 into omega t minus 120, and this is 3 omega t plus 120. Now 3 omega t minus 120 is same as 3 omega t minus 360. Okay, so this is 3 omega t minus 360 degree. This is here 3 omega t plus 360 degree. Now 360 is same as 0. So all become same expression. 3 omega t minus beta 3, this will go away, and this becomes 3 omega t minus beta 3, this also becomes 3 omega t minus beta 3. And we can extend this idea to triple harmonics, where n is equal to 3, 6, 9, 12, 15 and so on. Because 3 times of 120 is 360, or any number of 3 times. This is a multiple of 3 called triplet harmonics. So for triplet harmonics, this is always true that for n is equal to 3, 6, 9, 12 and so on, the multiples of 3. So these harmonics do not get cancelled. In fact, they will add up because they are cophasors. They have same angle. However, if you see the fundamental and the second harmonic components, if you add them, they are a balanced phasors. So this will go 0. This is also 0. But this is not 0. This is actually 3 times of I3 sine 3 omega t minus beta 3. Similarly, we can find out other components. Let us say 4, 5, 6. So 4, 5, 6 becomes, first is IA4. IA4 is nothing but I4 root 2 is here. Sine 4 omega t minus beta 4. The next one is 4 omega t minus 120 minus beta 4. And 4 into omega t plus 120 minus beta 4. The fifth one is 5 omega t minus beta 5, 5 into omega t minus 120 minus beta 5, and 5 into omega t plus 120 minus beta 5. And this is sixth one, 6 omega t minus beta 6, 6 omega t minus beta 6. The bracket has to come not inside but outside, correct it. This is 6 omega t minus beta 6. And then 6 omega t minus 120 minus beta 6, and 6 into omega t plus 120 minus beta 6. Again, this term will not cancel and they become same actually, because this becomes same as 0. So if I take this outside, this becomes 6 omega t minus beta 6 again. So this is 6 omega t minus beta 6, and if you simplify this, this also becomes 6 omega t minus beta 6. So as I said that these are cophasors and they will simply add up, and if you add them, it becomes 3 times of I6 sine 6 omega t minus beta 6. But if you add them again and simplify them, this time what will you see? The 4 omega t minus 120 degree becomes 3 plus 1. You can write 4 into 120. It will be written as 3 plus 1, 120. Now 3 into 120 is 0. So basically it becomes 120 degree. Okay, so it remains 120 degree only. So we can write this as 4 omega t minus beta 4 minus 120 degree. Am I correct? If you want, you can put this bracket, it's not required actually, but if you want, you can put it. Similarly, for C phase, it becomes 4 omega t plus 4 into 120. That 4 into 120 is same as 3 plus 1 into 120, which is also 120 degree. So this remains as 4 omega t minus beta 4 plus 120 degree. What about the fifth harmonic components? This is 5 omega t minus beta 5. What about this? 5 into minus 120. So if you say 5 into minus, or let's say 120 degree, is nothing but 3 plus 2. Okay, and 2 into 120 is same as minus 120. So plus 2 can be written as 3 minus 1 into 120, because this is 240 equals to minus 120. So finally it becomes minus 120 degree. So sign has changed. It was plus here, it becomes minus here. The sequence has changed. So this can be written as 5 omega t minus beta 5, and what is here? Plus 120 degree. And this becomes 5 omega t minus beta 5 minus 120 degree. Again, you will see they form the balance phasor. You can call it theta. You can call the whole thing as a theta. This is theta, this is theta, this is theta. So it's like a theta plus 0, theta minus 120, theta plus 120. If you add them, they are balance phasors. The sum is equal to 0. So this is also equal to 0, this is also equal to 0. But this is equal to 3 times of I6 sine 6 omega t minus beta 6. You can extend this idea to all next components 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and so on. Now, what do you observe here? The first thing is the nature of these components, because they are a multiple of 3. And these are non-triple harmonics 1, 2, 4, 5, and so on. Out of these harmonics, you see the 1, 4, 7, and so on, they form positive sequence component. Or I can say these set of components form three kinds of currents. Number one is 3 and plus 1, 3 n plus 2 and 3n. Okay, 3n plus 1 components are known as positive sequence component. And 3n plus 2 are known as negative sequence. And 3n forms the triplet and zero sequence component. Because they flow in the neutral, which forms the zero sequence current. Okay. Now what is n here? N is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. When n is 0, it is 1. When n is 1, it is 4. When n is 2, it is 7, and so on. So 1, 4, 7, 10, and so on, they form the positive sequence component. Why they form positive sequence component? Because the B phase voltage lags A phase by 120 degree. You can see here, this is minus 120. So it follows like 0, minus 120, plus 120. So sequence is ABC. But here, the sequence has changed. You can see here, this is theta, this is theta plus 120. So now B phase is leading Y 120 degree. So sequence has changed, and the C phase has become minus 120 degree. Now C phase is lagging. So the C phase is leading here, the C phase is lagging, and B phase is leading. So the nature of sequence has changed, and hence this is called negative sequence. So all 3n plus 2 terms form the negative sequence component. And then the remaining terms are the multiple of 3 called triplet harmonics. They form the zero sequence components. So you may ask the question that for three-phase unbalanced system, do we have the positive sequence component of second harmonic? Because here you see that 2, 5, 8 and so on, they form negative sequence only. That means basically that fifth harmonic does not have positive sequence and zero sequence. Am I correct? Or the second harmonic does not have any positive sequence component. You can see here, the second harmonic has only negative sequence component. The fifth harmonic has only negative sequence component. While as the fundamental has only positive sequence component, the fourth harmonic also is positive sequence component, and seventh also and tenth also. Now I am asking question, can the fundamental components not have the negative sequence component? The question is that the fundamental here has only positive sequence component. It has no negative sequence component. When it will have negative sequence component and zero sequence component? When there is an unbalance in it. So because of balanced harmonics, they have certain characteristics. If second harmonic is also unbalanced, then they will start having the positive sequence as well as zero sequence. Similarly, if the fifth harmonic components are unbalanced, they will start having positive sequence and the zero sequence. But if they are balanced, the fifth harmonic has only negative sequence component. I hope you got the point. So all 3n plus 1 has a positive sequence, 3n plus 2 is negative sequence, and 3n has a zero sequence component. Now let us closely observe the nature of the neutral current. That is very important. Okay? Neutral current is important because when you design the distribution network, or when you design the wiring for any building or any, let us say, data center, if there are triplet harmonics, these harmonics are not cancelled, rather they flow in the neutral wire. And sometimes the value of this neutral wire current could be as much as the phase currents. It depends upon the presence of the triplet harmonics or unbalance in the system. So you can see here, even though there is no unbalance, the triplet harmonics always get added up, as you can see from the previous discussion. So the IN current is nothing but 3 times of root 2 IH sine H omega t minus beta H, where H is from 369 to, let us say, infinity. We have just proved that they are added up because they are cophasors. So simply it becomes 3 times of the H phase current. So what is the RMS value of this neutral current? The RMS value will be 3 into the RMS of these terms complete. Okay, so if you find the RMS value of this, you have to find like this, I n RMS equals to 1 by t 0 to t I n square dt and square root of this. So this is the expression for the RMS value of the neutral current. And if we solve for this particular system where it consists of triplet harmonics, this can be written as I, let us say, in general, if I n has all components including DC, it can be written as IDC square plus I1 square plus I2 square and so on till I h square, h for some highest order harmonics, and square root of this. Now here DC component is not there, 1 is not there, 2 is not there, I3 is there. So I3 square plus I6 square plus I9 square and so on. So this becomes equivalent to I h square, where h is 3, 6, 9 and so on till infinity and square root of this. And then 3 times of this, because each phase contributes this amount of neutral current RMS value, and finally they are added up. Therefore, the total RMS value of the neutral current will be 3 times of sigma H 369 to infinity IH square and square root of the whole expression. This will be the rating of the neutral conductor. In practical cases, this rating could be comparable with the rating of the phase conductors. Particularly for data centers where they employ a number of UPS to supply the computers and other electronic load, the triple harmonics may contribute a significant rating, and it could be comparable with the rating of the phase conductors. That depends upon the magnitude of the triple harmonics present in the system. And particularly in data centers where we employ the number of computers supplied by UPS, this UPS takes the current from the supply, which is quite rich in third, fifth and seventh harmonics, and they may add up to high rating of the neutral conductor. In the next class, we will talk about the line-to-line voltage. So you have seen that in spite of the balanced nature of the harmonics, the neutral current may have sufficient rating because the triple harmonics do not get cancelled. But if you come to line-to-line voltage, the opposite phenomena happens. The triple harmonics get cancelled in line-to-line voltage. For example, if BAB and BBC and BCA are line-to-line voltages, then BAB, BBC and BCA can be written as BA minus BB, BB minus BC and BC minus BA. And if there are triple harmonics which are co-phasors, then the triple harmonic of A and the triple harmonics of B will get cancelled because of negative sign. So in line-to-line voltage, the opposite phenomenon happens to that of the neutral current. In neutral current, the triple harmonics get added up, but in case of line-to-line voltage, they get cancelled. For such cases, the relationship between BLL and BLN, which is normally is this, that BLL equals to root 3 times of BLN, is no longer true for 3-phase unbalanced system. So as you can see that this identity does not hold true for 3-phase unbalanced system as well as 3-phase balanced system with harmonics. Or I can say this is for balanced fundamental voltages. And this is not true for either unbalanced voltages or balance voltages with harmonics. And we will see in the next class that VLL is less or equal to root 3 times of VLN for 3-phase balanced system with harmonics.